Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are back with another Astakvaka video, and this is probably the most important video of the Astakvaka series because this video will tell us how to use Astakvakas for analyzing dashas, because whatever happens in our life is only because of the dashas. If dasha denies, then an event cannot happen. If dasha promises, then that event always happens 100%. And sometimes the dashas can also say two contradictory things simultaneously. So for example, sometimes the dasha can say you want to get married and you don't want to get married. So then people think that dashas are not giving answers. No, it's not like that. What happens is that time there is the confusion in the person that, oh, should I get married? Should I don't want to get married? So that confusion either results in the person getting married or to not get married. But it is not that the dasha is not able to say what is going to happen. So let us now analyze the chart, and I have added the Lagna chart and the Navamsha chart and the Vimshottari dashas also here, and the planets and the Astakvaka table also. And this is a Capricorn ascendance chart, and this person is one of my senior god brothers in my spiritual life. He's a extremely noble person and a very highly spiritual person, and therefore I thought it is very apt for me to use this chart. And there you go. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your chart or your Astakvaka, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos, where you will find the link to my website to book a reading with me. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Alright, so first things first. So whenever we look at anything, we always check the ascendant. So you can see here, number 10, which is Capricorn. So now I have purposefully not included the Astakvaka scores, the total scores here, so that you can practice without seeing it, okay? Because generally what happens, if we directly see the scores like this, then we get used to that old fake ideology that anything above 28 is good and anything below 28 is terrible. Alright, so now when you see like this, you have to see the individual points also. Although here also you can try to play around and see there are 36 points, there are 21 points, okay? But let's not do it that way. So let us see it like this, the way it is. So let us see the ascendant lord first. So number 10 is Capricorn. We'll see the ascendant and the ascendant lord. Okay. So just check what is going on. So don't go to 1, because this is 1 is not the first house. This is Aries. Okay. So when I say the Lagna, see the sign and go to that sign number. All right. So now you see that this is Capricorn, and in Capricorn, Sun has 4 points, Moon has 5 points, and Mercury has the highest points. Wow. Then Saturn has the least points. My God. Saturn anyways contributes the least amount of points, but here Saturn has the least amount of points. Now you see the game. Mercury is the lord of the ninth house. You see this sign, number 6, Virgo is there. That means spirituality will dominate his entire life, irrespective of any dasha, transit, or any other placements, any other yogas that he might have in his chart. But that is not all in all. We also have to check some other things, okay? So for example, if you look into the chart carefully, you will see that he has the Lord of the 10th house, which is Venus, and Mercury, the Lord of the 9th house, conjunct in the 9th house. And this, according to great sage Parashara, this is known as Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga, which is the highest of all the yogas that any man can have in his or her chart, man or woman, anybody. This makes the person practice spirituality, not only just speak about it or just read about it. Okay, he practices by he first learns and then he practices under a guru. And we already saw that in the Ashtavakra, in his ascendant, Mercury contributes the maximum points, 7 freaking points. It is almost double of Sun and Jupiter and Venus. Now Mercury, although he is the ninth lord, but he is ultimately Mercury. So what will he do with that Mercury? So he will be communicating, he will be talking, he will be preaching about spiritual life. And that is what he does. And he has been in he had done his master's from University of Dayton in United States, and there when he went almost 3-4 years back, the same time when I had come to Germany for my master's, so he had the moment he entered, within a very short span of 3-4 months, he just opened a club on spirituality, and he became very famous there because this Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga is active in his chart lifelong. This is like eternally, for his whole life this yoga will be working, and he's extremely fortunate and blessed to have this yoga. So now let us see the other things in the chart. So where is his Saturn? So his Saturn is placed in the 12th house. That can make a person very spiritual. Now Saturn in 12th house as the Lagna Lord can have 1,000 meanings. One meaning is that the person could be indulging too much in affairs, or can have extramarital relations, or can be least interested in marriage. Yes, contradictory things could be there. Or the person is very secretive by nature. Or the person is very spiritual. It can be either of these. It will depend on the entire chart where the flow is happening. And depending on that, you have to decide what is actually happening. Now, let us look at the chart here. You see the planetary positions in this table. Of course, we'll go to dashas, but we are just getting a vibe of the chart, what the chart is all about. So if you see the degrees, then moon occupies the highest degree in the chart, and moon is in 29 degrees, and therefore it has a very special position, which is known as the Atma Karaka in Jaimini astrology. And especially wherever the Atma Karaka is placed in the Navamsha can give a very big clue about what the person has been doing in his spiritual life. And in the Navamsha chart, if the Atma Karaka is linked with the trines, which is the 5th and the 9th, then this is exceptionally good. And somehow if the Atma Karaka is linked to Jupiter or the ascendant lord of the Lagna chart, this can also show great spiritual progress. Should I repeat? If the Atma Karaka is linked to Jupiter in the Navamsha chart, or it is linked to the Lagna of the ascendant chart, the D1 chart, okay, either way, it can show great spiritual progress. So now look at this, what is going on here. So you go to the Navamsha chart, and then in the Navamsha you see this moon is placed in the 9th house of spiritual progress and guru. So this Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga, which he has in the Lagna chart, is coming from his past lives. And now I told you, look Jupiter. So Jupiter and moon are very well associated, because moon is sitting in the sign of Jupiter, it is sitting in Sagittarius, which is the original ninth house of spirituality, and in the ninth house. So it's like from all three sides the power is coming, you see. And then you also see that moon is sitting in the sign of Sagittarius, where his Lagnesh in his birth chart is sitting. So condition number two is again fulfilled. Now this shows that inherently the chart is very, 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 very strong for spiritual progress. Any kind of spiritual practice the person does, he will do it with full heart and soul and commitment. And there are thousand other indications also of spiritual progress, about which we can discuss some other time. But the thing is, Atmakaraka's placement in the ninth house, in Jupiter's sign, and in the sign where his ascendant lord of D1, which is Saturn, is placed, shows great spiritual progress. And now if you see what is going on, if you check, he started his life with Sun Mahadasha. So let us come to Dashas now. So now let us go to the Ashtak Varga chart. So where is Sun? Sun is here. Sun is the boss here, you see. And now you go and see there are 2.4634446. All right, so these are the points which Sun is contributing. So where is Sun contributing the highest number of points? Sun is contributing to Pisces, which is his third house, 6 points, and to Gemini, which is his sixth house. Okay, so this can make the person travel too much and can give some displeasure, discomfort, and I would say lack of peace because of frequent travel. Okay, whenever the third house is linked with the Dusthanas, it can show difficulty in travel or trouble out of travel. And beginning his years, these 5 years, you can see he was born on 7th October. And in fact, I'm making this video today. Today is his birthday. And this person, he, in his childhood, for the first 5 years till July 1995, had a lot of travel and a lot of health problems were also there, and some other issues also the person faced. Now why that is happening? That does not happen just by Ashtak Varga. The whole chart has to indicate that. Okay, so here you see Sun is also the eighth lord. Okay, so eighth lord is placed in a ninth house. And if you see in the Navamsha chart, Sun is again placed in the fourth house. Okay, now Sun is inherently strong in the Kendras, no doubt, but because fourth house represents Patal, so it can show a lack of vitality, because fourth house is the house where Sun is in midnight. So it's like the, it's like saying, it does not mean, some people think that Sun in fourth house, Sun is not existing. No, it's not like that. Sun always existed and it always exists eternally, and it will continue to exist. So but if Sun is in the fourth house, then it is like saying, although the Sun is there, but I cannot feel the light of the Sun. Okay, and because of that, it can give us issues related to our body, especially when the dasha of this planet gets activated. So now Sun is in the fourth house, of course. So therefore, the issues he had faced, some health issues, some may not be very severe, but still reasonably good. Reasonably quite severe, that his whole life was going up and down for the first 5 years. And we can see that, and this up and down thing can also be seen as the eighth lord. But it is in the ninth house, so therefore some blessing of the gods are always there with him. And because it is in the sign of Mercury, so blessings of Vishnu is indicated in the sign of Mercury. And it is with Mercury again, and again Venus is there. So Sun, Mercury is Ram, and Sun, Mercury, Venus together can represent the blessings of goddess Sita. Sita Devi, definitely she has blessed him. Alright, so now let us go to his moon dasa. Moon 10 years, prime of his childhood and his teenage and all. No, not teenage exactly. So he'll be around, 15 that time almost. So that is like his entire childhood. So let us go to moon, what moon is telling. So moon is contributing 5 points here to the fourth house. Then again moon is contributing 7 points, you see there. Then again moon has 5 points to the seventh house, then 0 points to eighth house. And if you go like this, you can see where moon is contributing how much. So moon has a very strong agenda of Gemini, and that is again his sixth house. So now this same sixth house has now contributed differently for him, okay? Because in the Navamsha, you see moon is very well placed. It is in a great house. It's in the best house of the Navamsha, in fact. The ninth house of the Navamsha is the most important house. And this moon is also, if you check properly, it is also the dispositor of sun in the Navamsha. It is a very important planet, and also it is the Atmakaraka. So the dispositor of the of sun in your Navamsha chart can show your body or bodily strengths, okay? Because sun is the existence, and the existence manifests through the body, and the dispositor of sun in the Navamsha has the responsibility to maintain your body and your physique, okay? And here you see sun's dispositor is moon, because sun is in Cancer and moon is very well placed in the ninth house, and it is aspected by Mars from the third house. So this person was into martial arts and doing a lot of sports, being very heavily active, okay? And during this time the person became very much spiritually inclined. Now you may be thinking why that happened, just because moon is in the ninth house of Navamsha? Well, no, that's not the answer. Well, there are multiple reasons for this, because if you see, moon is the Atmakaraka. Okay, so whenever the Atmakaraka's dasha comes in somebody's life, Vimshottari dasha, in Vimshottari, the Mahadasha of the Atmakaraka, when it comes, it gives the ultimate purpose for why the soul had taken birth. Okay, and we had already cross-checked the Atmakaraka, seeing the link to Jupiter and Saturn of the Lagna chart, and because of that, inherently what will happen, irrespective of where moon is, what moon is doing, because of the Navamsha, all the spiritual memories and inclinations to spiritual growth and inclinations for spiritual progress and inclinations for getting connected to gurus will come out from his past. And because moon is extremely well placed here, therefore all these things will come out. So now you may be wondering, from where are these things coming? I mean, it's okay, the person is very spiritual, but the thing is, who in the universe is granting these blessings to this person? So if you see, moon is in the fourth house, and that means he's very much connected to his mother as the Atmakaraka in the fourth. But if you see, the fourth lord of Lagna chart, which is Mars, is aspecting this moon. So third house is the house of Upadesh, okay, Guru Upadesh. So it's like saying Mars, which is the lord of the fourth house of the Navamsha, is which can show mother and the Bhagya associated with the mother, is in the third house aspecting this Atmakaraka. So it is like a Guru and Shishya relationship, you see. So here the mother is acting as the one who is giving advice, and he is acting as the one who is listening, you know, in the 3-9 axis. It's a very beautiful axis. And surprisingly, Mars is the Navamsa Lagna Lord. That means he is internally fully into it. No compromise. Whatever his mother is saying, he is listening. This is like exactly in the Mahabharata, where Subhadra, one of the wives of Arjun and sister of Lord Krishna and Balaram, when she was having Abhimanyu in her womb, then Arjuna was describing to Subhadra that how to break Chakravyu. Chakravyu is a very lethal formation in the Vedic society, in the Vedic like the warfare, and very few people in the Kurukshetra war knew how to break the Chakravyu. So Krishna was one of them, Arjuna was one of them, and Abhimanyu was one of them, and of course Dronacharya was also one of them, and some versions of the Mahabharata say that Ashwatthama also knew, and some say that no, Ashwatthama did not know. But anyways, the point here is this is exactly like the mother is speaking and he is listening. So he always tells me that his mother is the source of his spiritual progress. So it's very clearly visible here, you see. And then his Mars Mahadasha started. So during his Mars Mahadasha, you can check in Ashtavakra, it's going again the sixth house, you see. Again, Gemini has 6 points there. It's a whole lot of contribution towards the sixth house. And the other houses, Mars doesn't look to be that interested in. So what did you do during these years, during these 7 years? So if you look closely to his chart, he met his guru when he had come to SRM University in Chennai, the same college where I did my bachelor's. I was in software engineering and he was in information technology. So when was that period? So that was the that very famous year for him. 2009 was the year. So the engineering college starts from July or June, or in some places August, and therefore 2009 batch, it's almost 10 years. So this date which you are seeing here, this is the end date, all right, end date of Saturn. So Saturn ended during January 2009, and then Mercury went on from January 2009 to January 2010, all right. And Mars and Mercury, these two planets gave him association with his guru, and he met his guru, and recently he also got initiated by that guru in the West, in America, somewhere in Houston, I believe. And he is leading an extremely happy life, and he also got married recently. We will try to see all the events, okay. So now you see what Mars is interested. According to Ashtavakra, Mars is primarily interested in Gemini again. Gemini is again his sixth house, alright. So that means till the dasha of Mars, this person may not be very much inclined towards getting married. That could be one possibility. And apart from that, it could also happen that the person is very much focused on following Brahmacharya, celibacy, all right. And that is very true. 2009 10 11 12 9 10 11 12, these 3 years, 4 years, this Mars in the Navamsa chart, it is Lagnesh, and seventh from the Atmakaraka, Mars is placed. So this is a very, very, very prominent placement. So whenever a planet is placed in the seventh from the Atmakaraka in the Navamsa, it can show that those desires which you always wanted to fulfill, those desires will become lively in your life, okay. But that does not mean your desires get fulfilled. For that, you have to check what is happening in the Lagna chart. So if you see here, Mars is placed in Taurus in the fifth house, and fifth house is the best house for any planet, in fact 5 and 9 the trines. So therefore we can say that his search for mantra, which is the fifth house, will be fulfilled finally, and he will find a guru who under whom he can finally take diksha or initiation. And this is a very powerful placement because the dispositor of this Mars has again gone to the ninth house, participating in the Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga. So that means he has got these back to back two dashas which are promising great spiritual progress. And because the dispositor of Mars is in the ninth house, Venus, so therefore he will find a guru. And because Mercury is the one participating in this, being the lord of the ninth, so during Mercury's antardasha he found his guru, he met his guru, and later on these years were fully spent on core spiritual practices, getting up almost at 3 a.m. in the morning and doing serious mantra chanting and so many other practices. He is very well versed in the Srimad Bhagavatam, he is very well versed in the Bhagavad Gita, he is extremely knowledgeable. And there you go, this Mars Dasha has had been extraordinary for him. So now let us go to this Rahu Mahadasha, which started in July 2012. So now Rahu does not have there are no points there, you see, you don't have Rahu Ketu. So what do you do? So what we do is we check where Rahu is placed, okay, and then we check those Ashtavarga points, I mean the points which are there in that house, okay. So now Rahu is in Capricorn, Rahu is greatly placed in Capricorn. And if you see here Capricorn, what is going on? You see Moon and Mercury are throwing so much contribution there. Moon has 5 points and then Mercury has 7 points, and that means Moon and Mercury's agenda will be at the peak, okay. So now this is a precarious situation, because why do I say that? Because Mercury is the sixth lord and Moon is the seventh lord. Mercury is also the ninth lord, of course. So now his Moon is telling him that get married, but Mercury is telling him that don't get married, okay. But if you check closely here, Mercury is also the ninth lord here, okay. And therefore there is no hindrance to marriage, because the houses 5 and 9 they always tend to get you married, even if the houses of marriage are 2nd, 7th and 11th. So had this been some other house like the 3rd or the 4th or the 12th or the 10th, then the person would have never got married. But because this is the ninth house, which is the continuation of your father's lineage, so therefore this person will be more inclined towards marriage, okay. Oops, there is some error. And therefore this person will now want to marry, because this Mercury is again with Venus there, you see. And if you check in the Navamsha chart what is going on, again here Moon is the lord of the fourth house, again he is sitting in the ninth house, okay. So again settlement is there on cards. And apart from that we also have Mercury, okay. So Mercury is debilitated in the 12th house, so this means that this Rahu Dasha can take him abroad. Okay, because this this Mercury, which is the ninth lord, is contributing quite a bit to Capricorn, which is his Lagna. And this Mercury in the Navamsha is in the 12th house, and that too it is in debility. So when a planet is debilitated in the Navamsha, it can happen that it might seem as if you are forced to do something which you not necessarily which you don't want, but it's like you don't have any control or any say in that situation. So in his case also, he always tells me that he never dreamt of going to the US or doing masters, but somehow things happened so fast. In fact, he used to tell me that till 2013, in fact, he had no inclination. But somehow after 2013, after 2014, in fact, so many things happened by the end of 2013, and finally he came to US by the mid, or I would say during this Jupiter period, he came to US. Okay, and then his Jupiter Dasha started. And Jupiter, if you see in the chart, let us see what Jupiter is telling. Jupiter is having eight points, you see, to Taurus, which is number two, which is his fifth house. And Jupiter is having again 7 points to his second house. So that means this is the time when he can get initiated, when he can when he can finally get the mantra diksha from his guru, and he can finally be initiated. And before the Jupiter Antardasha ended, so Jupiter Antardasha ended in August 2017, he got initiated around February or March 2017. So that was the time he got initiated. And Jupiter in his Lagna chart is exalted. It is in Cancer, great placement. It is in Pushya Nakshatra, as you can see. And in the Navamsha, it is with the dispositor of this Atmakaraka, which was in fact giving him all spirituality. And it is also in the 8th house. Now 8th house of the Navamsha can have challenges materially, but if the planet is used spiritually, it can give great results, great benefits to this person. And Jupiter also is in the 7th house, as you can see here. All right, and this Jupiter in the Navamsha has been aspected by this Venus, which is the 7th lord. So that means he can also get married during this dasha, or he might find somebody who could be one of the probable persons with whom he might get married, or he might like somebody at least. These kind of things can happen. Okay, but something to do with marriage will be there. All right, and later on what happens, you see Saturn Antardasha starts, and he is running Saturn another almost 9 to 10 months of his life. Till July next year, he will be running Saturn's Antardasha. So let us go to Saturn. What is Saturn telling? So just check Saturn here. Saturn has 5 points to his 4th house, which is Aries. Then Saturn has 1 point to Capricorn. Wow. Saturn is like not interested in his own house itself, you see. And again 5 points to his 2nd house, which is Aquarius. And Saturn has 4 points to his 7th house, which is Cancer. And here again this Saturn is aspected by Venus, which is the 7th lord of the Navamsha chart. And Saturn is also conjoined the dispositor of Moon, which is Jupiter. So therefore Saturn becomes a very, very, very strong contender for marriage. And indeed, he got married in the Saturn's Antardasha. And for marriage especially, the Lagna chart should support the 2nd and the 7th and the 11th. Okay. Otherwise, marriage is very difficult, because when you say you get married, you don't get married to anybody, you know, or to nobody. You get married to a person, and for that, the physical body, the physical existence of the person has to come in front of you, which can come from the 2nd and the 7th and the 11th houses. Okay, and Saturn is the lord of the 2nd house, we can see that. And therefore, he becomes a very strong contender for marriage, and he's in Purvashada Nakshatra here. Saturn is in Purvashada, and the lord of the Nakshatra is Venus, which is again in the ninth house and is the lord of the fifth house. Okay, so therefore this person got married during this Antardasha of Saturn, and currently he is living a very happy life. His wife is also there with him, and he is currently somewhere in Los Angeles, and he is having a great time spiritually. He has got initiation now, and he just got married. And now let us have a look at his future. Okay, let us look at Mercury. So his Mercury period will be starting after some time, after July next year, and this will be a very prominent period according to Ashtavakra. Why? Because Mercury has the highest contribution to his Lagna, okay, to Capricorn, and therefore he will always be waiting, when will Mercury's time period come? Alright, when will Mercury come so that I can implement my plans and my actions, my desires? So I have already congratulated him for this Mercury period, which is going to be a fantastic period for him, because finally he will get to do what he always wanted, and now he is planning to open his spiritual academy or some online course or something like that. He is planning to do that, and I have told him that as soon as August starts, bang on, everything will start and you will be able to do everything fully without any hurdles. And if you see Mercury here, it has 6 points for the second house, the sign Taurus, number 2, which is his 5th house, okay. So the 5 and 9, these two are the trines. So his trines are getting active. So it's like saying that he will feel lively again, or he will feel as if life has come back to him after Saturn, okay. And he will be doing all high level spiritual practices. And the thing is, because Mercury is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra in the birth chart, therefore he will not do it alone. He will do it with people. He will collaborate with other spiritual people, and he will sign contracts, deals, negotiations, and many other things he will do, because Uttar Falguni is the nakshatra for collaborations and understanding that you can do much better when you are together. Okay, and now before we go, let us just keep an eye on Saturn, because he got married during this dasha. So if you see Saturn has 5 points to the 4th house, okay, which is Aries, and then Saturn also has 5 contribution to Gemini, which is his 3rd house, 6th house, and then Saturn again has contribution to the 2nd house. So the 2nd and the 6th houses of money. So that means Saturn wants that he earn a lot of money, and the mother will become very prominent, and he also got a very big job in US during this time, because Saturn wants him to focus on the Artha houses, and that's what he did also. And so now what happened is his mother is indicated, you see. So the 4th house, which is Aries, has 5 points from Saturn. So therefore we can infer that his mother will have a very strong say in his marriage, okay. And if you look carefully in the chart, the 7th lord is sitting in the 4th house, okay. So the 7th lord in the 4th can show that the mother can decide the spouse, okay, or you can say the mother can help in deciding the spouse. These are some kind of indications which you can get. So but many people will have 7th lord in the 4th, but it will not happen for everybody. So you also have to check the Ashtavakra. So there you see in the Ashtavakra also, we can see Saturn is very much interested in the 4th house. So whatever Saturn does in the chart, depending on the placement, he will always be interested in the mother, okay. And therefore this the girl with whom he got married, what happened was she's from a different community. Like for example, she is Gujarati, and he Sindhi himself. So in India, if a Gujarati or a Sindhi gets married together, it is like a inter-caste marriage, as they say. And I had already told him, because Saturn and Rahu are involved, both of them are malefics, so it is highly unlikely that you will end up marrying somebody from your caste, creed or community. Okay, so therefore he took a note of this point, and when he had told me that I had found a girl, my mother found a girl, she's a Gujarati, and she said that his mother told that the girl is very good, you should come and see her. And then when he saw her, he also liked her and she also liked him, and then finally they got married. So there you see again the dasha planets which give you marriage. You can see the Ashtavakra and get an idea of where your spouse can come from. Okay. And because Saturn is again contributing 5 points to his second house, so the girl can come from the side of the family. So here mother and family are the same only. I mean, mother is a part of the family. So either the mother or somebody else from the family could have suggested. Okay. So these are, this is the way by which you can get some idea of the dashas, and you can try to see what is going on in his Lagna chart and Navamsha chart, and you can also use Jaimini astrology to understand. And many people have been asking me to make another video on Atma Karaka and the Jaimini Karakas using Ashtavakra. So I will try to make another video on those topics also. Let me see when I can make it. All right. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if you like this, click the thumbs up and share it with others. And if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Ashtavakra, you can go to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Thank you so much.